So my topic today is a bit different from the normal topic. It is Agile and Lean Movie Making. So am I here to talk about movie making? Of course, no. Okay. And by the way, neither I'll be able to teach you something on Agile and Lean. What I'm going to do is I'll just share my experience of implementing Agile and Lean in my business, movie making, okay? And how we get benefited out of it. So I remember my grandmother used to say, life itself is a drama, okay? And we all play different role in this drama, okay? Or different characters in this drama. So we play the character of a father, of a mother, of a son, of a daughter, like that. And what I believe is all of us having some creative thing inside us, okay? Someone is having some characteristics of an actor, an actress, a director. So what I normally do is, in most of the conferences that I attend, I start my session with the golden buzzword, the three golden buzzword of cinema, okay? This is because I would like to, in the respect of all great movie makers, I start the session with the golden buzzword. So anyone knows what are the golden buzzwords of cinema? Yeah, that is one. So it is basically lights, camera, and action. So what I will do is, I will start this session in the respect of those great movie makers with light, camera, and action. So everybody can tell me, and you know this, right? This is called clapper. This is the integral part of movie making, okay? So each scene starts with this, okay? So I will clap this, and we'll start, we all will say lights, camera, and action, these three words. Okay, so if everyone can say lights, camera, and action. Thank you. So we'll start our session now. So with due respect to our sponsors, I mean, definitely it is because of them we can have this kind of conferences all over the world. It is not only here. In India also, we do the same. And all respect goes to our sponsors. With that about me, I am a delivery manager in a chemical research and development company. At the same time, I am creative director for two of the, in fact, three of the parallel Bollywood movies. One movie is currently under production. So, as I said, I'll share my experience, so I'll give a little background about myself. So, I come from the northeastern part of India, where the creativity blooms despite poverty and political instability. Okay, there are a lot of political instability and poverty, but despite that, the creativity blooms there. So, you can see the city, and these are some great people. Satyajit Ray, he's a filmmaker. He got Oscar in 1992. Rabindranath Tagore, he got Nobel in Literature in 1913. So I graduated in science. I was studying science, but I was always inclined towards arts, culture, and cinema from my childhood. And to enrich my creativity. Box office is nothing but it is the collection from theaters and multiplexes. So apart from box office, there are other sources of income also, like satellite right, music right, and all other things. But we failed badly in box office. So all our movies, small movies, were flops. Then we made a big attempt. And we put all our money and energy into it. Okay, so our producer, put all his money and we put all our energy into this movie. Although this movie was appreciated a lot and awarded a lot, but unfortunately it is a big failure at box office. Again, we lost everything, and I mean, we have not been able to get even what we invested. It's a medium budget film, no star cast, there were no star, no mass experience, very chaotic while shooting, and a failure in box office. Then, here now the Agile starts, the Agile and the Lean journey comes into picture. So, our entire team was completely depressed, and we are analyzing that how movie making can be profitable and predictable, okay? Definitely, movie is for entertainment, but behind that, you spend a lot of money. And we want that money to be back after releasing that. And we started analyzing the reason. So this is the box office statistics. So if you look at, movie is a very big project. An average Hollywood movie budget is more than 100 million. Okay, so this is an average. I'm not talking about a Spider-Man and all of that. So those budgets are much more. And the market is also very big. The global box office revenue is close to 40 billion. Only the box office billion. So movie industry as itself is a very big industry. And these are the number of movies. India being the leader, every year it releases around 1,100 movies. And followed by USA, Japan, China, France, Germany and all. And if you look at this return on investment curve, okay, so we see that approximately 70% of our movies, they lose money worldwide. I'm not talking about Hollywood or Bollywood or something like that. 70% of the movies, they lose money. So what we say is saving cost at every stage of movie making and a systematic production execution methodology or approach is very, very important to make movie making profitable. Now this is the same representation, but here you see 70% loses money, and out of those 70%, only 15% of the movies, they could get a good return on investment. That means they are blockbusters. You can say somewhere it says hits and super hits. It means if your movie budget, I mean if your earning is double the movie budget, then it is hit. If it is more than that, it is a blockbuster. So these are some, then what we did is, we started analyzing the reasons, what could be the reason for failure of most of the movies. And we found these are some of the factors that affecting the ROI of the movie. And out of those, most important is a poor production execution and over production cost. And if you look at all the factors, you can relate it to all the seven types of wastes in our Six Sigma Lean world. So you people are already aware of Six Sigma. So all the seven wastes are found here. And this is kind of a calculation. With that, you can do a predictive analysis that what will be my total box office collection of a movie. So we analyze that. And these are the factors that are basically related to a proper production execution methodology, and some of the waste in the entire value stream of movie making. So it's a process, so it's a value stream. If you look at Lean value stream or a Kanban value stream, so it has got a lot of waste in the value stream. And the production execution methodology, that means how we make the movie. So if you look at a movie, a normal traditional way of movie making, so it is a waterfall. Okay, you have got different phases. You have a pre-production phase, wherein you prepare the screenplay and all those things. Then you go to shooting, which is a production phase. Then you have a post-production, wherein you do editing, dubbing, putting songs and all those things. Okay, so this is a waterfall way. And this waterfall way, you see a lot of waste, as well as it is unpredictable. Because while you do shooting, okay, you shoot everywhere and bring all those footage, the shootings, into editing table. Okay, at that time you don't know whatever you were shooting, whether exactly what you thought of that
will come out as your movie.
So what normally happens is a bad quality, not even up to the expectation of a director or producer, because you don't know what you are shooting and what the final product will look like. Huge wastage due to not considering which to shoot where and when. So here I'll talk about the Moscow technique. So everybody knows about Moscow technique. How we can implement Moscow technique in prioritizing the scenes in a movie. Wastage due to early production, overproduction by blocking money for a long time, not considering time to market. Again, the lean world comes into picture. Wastage due to delay, wait time in the different stages of movie making. Wastage due to reshoot, to recreate deviation. So you do in a waterfall way, okay, sometimes you look at, no, this is not what exactly we wanted. Then you reshoot, you recreate, okay, then again a huge wastage of money. Huge wastage due to, again, if you reshoot, then transportation, relocation, food, other expenses, then again. And movie team is very big, you know. If you see only 10 people acting on the screen, there will be 200 people behind the scene. They'll be working. So it's a very huge product, and it's a very complex process too. Wastage due to over-processing, due to over-concern. So here also lean world comes into picture. I'll not discuss much into this. Then what we found finally is the creative, normally what we do is we think that creative issue is the main culprit for a movie being not successful. But we found is in all the cases, creative issues cannot be blamed. Okay, there are other factors also apart from the creative thing. So we then realized that movie making is a costly affair and involves risks and uncertainties. The agile approach of incremental movie making makes it more predictable and risk resilience. He's the gentleman, he is our director and producer. So, and now the agile, what we thought is the entire team, we thought then like Agile Manifesto, we'll have Movie Making Manifesto. And we'll apply this manifesto, these techniques, in each and every movie that we are going to do next time. So it's a paradigm shift. Our aim is to satisfy the audience through timely delivery of engaging and entertaining movies. And we welcome changes even late in the development. Okay? So anytime you bring change in your screenplay, if you feel that this particular seed is not fitting into our requirement, we can change it at the last stage also. That is nothing but Agile. We empower the team. Our team, the cast and crew, sharing the responsibility of delivering the complete movie as per the writer and director's vision. So it is not only director and producer driving the entire show, it is the team empowered, and they will be driving the entire show. Experimenting, prototyping, shared learning, and using effective tools will make movie making process faster and more effective. So we used a lot of tools. So I'll discuss those in my later slides. And finally, our focus should be eliminating waste or any wasteful activities in the entire value stream of movie making. So we listed down all the activities that we do in a day, in a week, in a month, for the entire movie making process. And against each activity, we try to find out whether it is directly or indirectly giving any value to our process or not. If it is not giving, then we eliminate those. And next time we implement the same process in different cycles. Okay, so eliminate all the waste in the entire value stream. So these are the roles and responsibilities. We decided the roles and responsibilities. Because see, if you go to the movie making in the shoot, okay, in a set, movie set, okay, there are a lot of people, 100, 200 people, okay, and it is very difficult to control them. And who is taking what role is a bit difficult, okay? So in any movie making, you will see that chaotic kind of a scenario. So we define the role very clearly. So producer who is investing money in our project is nothing but he is the agile client. But actually, our agile client is our end customer, that is audience. Okay, but we're gonna see the audience there, right? So producer is spending money, so there producer is the end client. Scrum Master, of course, the director takes the Scrum Master role. This is the Agile team, the entire cast and crew, starting from your cameraman to all lights department, every department. Writer is the product owner. Many cases, or most of the cases, writer and director are the same. Okay, so director writes the script and movies. So a movie is made three times, basically. If you look at one movie, when you write the movie, you write the screenplay, when we actually shoot, and when you edit. So it is basically made three times. We created stories and epics out of the scenes. So we find out the minimum amount of shoot that will come into a particular user story, and how we can relate or combine those user stories as an epic. So we did it in that way. We introduced prototyping with a storyboard in our movie. So prototyping is very, very important, because the entire vision is within the director and the writer. To transfer or transfuse that vision to the entire team who will be actually doing shooting, or who will be actually arranging the set, or handling the camera and all those things, it is very, very important that you should have some kind of a prototyping mechanism. Okay, it could be some kind of diagram. There are a lot of tools there. You can have some animations. And this is very, very important to transfuse whatever you are thinking to the entire team of 200 people who will be actually executing the thing. So it is much more challenging. Okay, you have got very less time. And in normal movie, if you look at your normal cast and crew, not cast, the crew changes every day, because you give it to a production company. And the production company, today they will send some other technician, tomorrow they will send some other technician. So it is very difficult to transfuse that kind of information, the creative information, to the people. So for that, some kind of a prototyping tool or prototyping mechanism is very, very important. We did Moscow technique. So we used to have different buckets for different scenes. Suppose I have got 100 shooting locations or 50 shooting locations. Okay, normally it used to be 90 days shooting, 120 days shooting kind of thing. And we used to use the Moscow technique to prioritize our scene and to fall those scenes into the different buckets, okay, of different locations that we are going to do the shooting. And it was very, very helpful. It was very, very effective. We use, because 200 people, so you need something for collaboration. It is very, very important that you collaborate in a very good manner. So we used some kind of collaboration tools. We developed some purchased some simple mobile apps, okay? And with that mobile app, we can pass on the information to the entire team in a second, okay? And they will get the information. In fact, in that app, we used to have a Kanban board or a Scrum board, wherein people can see how the scenes are moving, different or tasks are moving, okay? So collaboration is very, very important. So we did collaboration. Now I'm coming to a very, efficient technique that, in fact, we thought in the Agile world, we bought it, but I don't know, maybe I'm wrong, but it is already there in movie making, which is called ambitioning. So this technique or this practice is followed by many of the big production houses in Hollywood and in Bollywood and in other industries. The ambitioning can be easily related to daily Scrum meeting, okay? So normally, this is not something we adopted, okay? We took it from a movie industry. It's already there in movie industry, this ambitioning process. So ambitioning is nothing but, before daily shooting, they have to have 1 hour of meeting. In that 1 hour, they decide that these are the scenes that we are going to shoot today. And at the end, we'll be editing that. We'll have a small movie kind of a thing. We'll look at, if you find it okay, then fine. Otherwise, what we'll do? Next day we'll shoot. So it is an incremental delivery, okay? Rather than having the waterfall way of doing all the shooting for 1 month, 2 months, and bringing all those things into editing table and find out, no, these scenes are not the exact what we are looking for, then you cannot go back. Because if you want to go back then you have a huge cost associated with that. You have to move the entire cast and crew again to that location. You need all those things and then only you can shoot. So this envisioning process was already available in movie industry, and we adopted that, or we refined it a little bit with the agile world of Scrum. And for this envisioning, we used some kind of a story mapping, we used some animation and brainstorming kind of methods so that all the cast and crew can easily understand what we are going to shoot today. So it looks like something like this. So I have got all the backlogs of shots, scenes, and then it is coming like that. Okay, so you found out something like this. Now, this is also one technique which is already available in movie industry. So it is nothing new. This is called postmodern. Okay, what is nothing but retrospective. So I'll tell a little bit about this particular technique. So periodically, they will have a meeting wherein they will find out the top, they will ask the entire cast and crew, not entire cast and crew, basically the leads, the five top things that you would like to do again, and five top things that you would like to avoid. And what they used to do is, next day, they will put all those findings in a board, and whoever comes into the shooting, they will first look at the board, and then only they will enter into the set. Because it is very difficult to announce or give some handouts or something like that. They will put in a board. So whoever is coming into the set, they will first look into those do's and don'ts, and then only they will be entering into the set, and they will act accordingly. So this practice, the postmodern practice, was already available, and we refined it and we implemented it in our movie. We did on the set editing. So this is incremental delivery kind of a thing, what I was discussed. So each day, whatever shooting we did a editing, we did some kind of a dubbing, put some voices, and at the end of the day, in the evening, we used to see it and we used to see whether we are getting what we have expected out of that particular day. So this is the incremental delivery kind of a thing. Okay, so it is a agile process. Now, another thing is, feedback is very, very important in the agile world. So in movie making, how we will get the feedback from your end audience? It is very difficult, right? So there are some techniques through which you can get the feedback from your audience. Like you release some kind of trailers or some kind of promos, the trailer of the movie. So time to time, and you don't release this at the end. Okay, when you start shooting, you start releasing your promos. And what the film critics will do, they will look at those promos, okay, and they will give you feedback. And they give their feedback not only of their own observation, but they will take audience voting. How you like this kind of a trailer or a promo, okay? And then they will publish their reviews and promos, reviews in different newspapers, different websites and something like that. So you get early feedback from your end audience. So this is also a technique, because the feedback is very, very important. If you get feedback, then you have a scope that you can change something. If some song, because in many Bollywood movies you will see there are songs. If some song is not, people are not liking, then you have a chance to change it. If a particular scene, people is not liking, or if a particular character, people is not liking, then you can change it. So you get early feedback from the audience through different means, not directly, because you cannot directly interact with the audience. As I said, we used Kanban boards, a lot of Kanban boards, okay? Not only for the shooting part of it, but for everything, for property, for all other equipments and all those things, we used Kanban board to track how our tasks are moving, okay? And this is very, very important. And also, we started collecting some kind of matrices, because it is very, very important Because all quantitative analysis is important so that you can track how things are going, okay? And if you have to revert back something, or if you have to take some corrective actions, so you can take it. So we used to collect lead time, cycle time, we used to draw cumulative flow diagrams out of that, and we used to see how our things are moving. So these are some of the matrices that we used to collect: lead time, cycle time, cumulative flow diagram. Also, we use many Six Sigma Lean techniques. So definitely I'm not going to discuss those here, because again, these Lean things are not in the scope of this conference. So we are mainly talking about Agile. But we use many cost-cutting plus eliminating waste kind of a thing. And out of that, one is hot cost sheet. So hot cost sheet is something, your daily shooting budget or production budget, you compare that budget with your previous day's budget, and every day you try to find out the areas where you can improve, or where you can do some cost cutting, or where you can eliminate some kind of waste out of that. Okay, so we implemented those techniques. So our accountant is to see the the hot sheet and compare it with the previous day's hot sheet, and it was very, very effective. So, and apart from that, as I said, we have used a lot of Lean techniques which are not in the scope of this, I think, presentation. And finally, we got some better products. So Amina is one movie that will be released very soon. This was Extraordinary, was already released. So we got approximately 14% total saving on those movies, 14%. So what budget, in a waterfall way or normal way, we did, okay, after implementing those techniques, the Agile and Lean techniques, we get 14% direct cost saving out of that. And now I will discuss some of the few other things that could have been implemented to make it much more better. And then finally, I have one answer to a group of people. So I'll first talk about this. So we could have further fine-tuned our entire value stream of production using some more Lean techniques. Okay, this was missing. Okay, we could have done that. Techniques like parallel day and night shooting of independent scenes can be done to crash the schedule, because in movie making, your schedule is more, then definitely your cost of production is more. So you can do parallel shooting, okay? Your director can do a shooting, and one your associate director can do shooting, and in thus you can crash the schedule, okay? And once you crash the schedule, then definitely you are saving a lot of money. Deal with creative constraints impacting cost and schedule of the movie by using advanced tools and techniques. So we could have used some more advanced tools and techniques. We could have done some comprehensive risk identification and mitigation. So this was not done, because again, movie making, there are a lot of risks associated with that. Okay, suppose some fire on the set, okay, something is missing. You are not carrying a battery of your camera to a remote location where you are shooting. Then, I mean, these are some of the risks, and you need to mitigate those risks. So that could have been done. A workshop could have been done, okay, to train the actors and actresses so that they can perform better. And thus also, you can save a lot of shooting. Otherwise, you have to do shoot, and then cut, and then shoot, and then cut. I mean, it is not perfect. So you can do some kind of a workshop, okay, wherein you can train your characters or actors and actresses, and thus you can. So these things were missing in our, these things. And finally, okay, so this you people know already. I'll talk a little bit about the effective tools and techniques. So this scene you know, right? And this is from Life of Pi, okay? And very interestingly, the Life of Pi, the entire shooting was done in a swimming pool. Okay? So the ocean episode that you see, it was not at all done in ocean. It was in this swimming pool, okay? And very interestingly, the Royal Bengal Tiger that you see on the movie, there was no Royal Bengal Tiger on the set. It was a VFX object. Okay, so I mean, otherwise, if you have to do shooting with a Royal Bengal Tiger, it would have been costly and dangerous too. This is a battle scene from one of the Indian movies. Okay, so we look at the battle scene. So this is done with only 100 soldiers. Okay, and then they used a technique called crowd multiplication. And then they made it like thousands and thousands of soldiers are standing there. So this is the technique. So you can use those techniques to, because if you do this kind of a shooting, you have to do, I mean, originally, then it is very difficult. Okay, you can use some techniques and you can do it. Similarly, just for an example, this is from Avatar, movie Avatar. So here, if you look at the facial expression of these characters, it is taken from these human beings. Okay, to make it more perfect, to bring the emotion on the faces. Okay, so what they use is they used a technique. This is a high technique called facial motion capture, okay? And through which they capture the emotion of the faces and impose those emotions into the characters to make it more perfect and more, visual reality to be bring. So, as I said, we get better predictable products, okay? Some other movies are also going on. And we are implementing the same kind of techniques there. And what we found out is, if we do these techniques in a proper way, because ours, what we did was in a crude way. It was not very, very good, okay? Because we have just started that. So in different heads, these are different expenses. You can save up to 20% of your production budget if you use Agile and Lean kind of a technique, and 20% is huge. Okay, we got 14% only implementing in a crude way. Okay, but you can save up to 20%. So I have just shown it in a conventional way. The expenses goes in this way, in an Agile and Lean way, it goes in this way. And finally, this is one message I would like to give to the group of people, okay? Because nowadays I can see in many conferences and many blogs and many newspapers and many webinars that Agile is dead. What is next? RIP. Kind of, these things are coming. Lean is dead. So I would like to give a message to those group of people who thinks Agile is dead or Lean is dead. From my experience, from our experience as a novice movie maker. So what we have learned from our journey. So what I am going to say is, do not associate or limit Agile and Lean with any specific industry. Don't limit the scope of Agile and Lean with any specific industry, like manufacturing and only in IT. Don't limit it. It's versatile. It's a methodology of working which can be applied in any industry, any business, in any work, even in your personal life. Your personal work also, you can implement it. The more you practice Agile and Lean, the more you mature and invent. Okay, it is not like that. These are the few techniques, daily scrum and some sprint and all those things, that's all in Agile. The more you practice, the more you learn, and you can learn and you can invent your own practice. Okay, that can be aligned with Agile and Lean. And there is no end to it. So your practices, you mature and you invent. Many a times, this is also our experience, many a times we do many things unknowingly in Agile and Lean way. And we get amazing results. And we think, wow. But if you look at and then analyze, behind that, there is some Agile or Lean techniques are hidden there. Okay? So this is the message I would like to give to the entire audience, that Agile and Lean cannot be dead. Okay? It's a process that can be invented, reinvented, and reinvented. And with that, I think I'm ready for taking any kind of questions. This is just, I have just shared my experience and our team's experience. So any kind of I mean, somebody wants to start implementing Agile and Lean in their own business, which is not IT, which is something else, okay? They can always contact me, okay? I'm available on Twitter and LinkedIn. I can help them how it can be modified, it can be used, it can be implemented in any business, in any type of work, any kind of thing. Definitely you have to look it into a different angle, what we did in our experience. Okay, so hearing none, so hope no questions, but as I said, I'm available on Twitter and LinkedIn and Facebook. So thank you very much, and thank you the Agile Bosnia Association to giving me the opportunity to come over here from India and share my experience, share my views in this conference. Thank you. Thank you very much.